So you've just got your first Eurorack module. Unlike other tools and instruments on the market, your new module will take a little more setup than just turning on the power and plugging into a mixer. In this video, we will show you how to mount and power your module to be used in a Eurorack system. The first thing you'll need is a Eurorack case of some type with an included power supply. There are all sorts of options when it comes to cases and power, but in general, they all work similarly to one another. Keep the case disconnected from power while installing new modules. This will eliminate any chance of shorting any connections by accidentally bumping the PCB on the metal rails while installing the module. Next, unpack your Eurorack module. Be careful while handling the module with the PCB exposed, as a shock from static electricity can damage the components. Discharge your body by touching a piece of metal before touching anything on the back of a module. A new module should come with a power cable and a set of screws. Depending on the module, you may receive a wider power cable with 16-pin connections on both sides, or a more narrow cable with a 10-pin connector on one side and a 16-pin connector on the other. There are varying screw sizes for different modules and rail systems. Your case will use either thickness M2.5 or M3 screws. Module panels that are 1.5 millimeters thick will use 6 millimeter long screws, while 2 millimeter panels will use 8 millimeter screws. All WMD modules include M3 screws at 8 millimeters, and some modules include a set of plastic washers. For this demo, we're using a 16 to 16 pin cable. Plug one end of the cable into your power supply's bus board. You'll want to match the red stripe on the cable to the negative 12 volt side of the power header. This will have an indicator of some type on the power supply. If in doubt, check your manual for your specific power supply to see which side is the negative 12 volt rail. Now, you can plug the other side of the cable into your module. Again, most modules should have an indicator for the negative 12 volt rail. Match the red stripe on the cable to the indicator on the module. All WMD and WMD SSF modules are protected from reverse polarity, so there are no worries if you accidentally plug the cable in backwards. However, not all brands of modules are protected, and no matter what, the module will not power up if the cable is connected incorrectly. Now that you're plugged into a power supply, it's time to install the module into the case. Align the holes on the module with the threads of your inserts or sliding nuts in your rails, and use the included screws to fasten the module to the rails. Don't over-tighten the screws, as it can damage the panel of your module and can make it difficult to remove modules from your system later. Supply power to the case. If you've done everything properly, you should now see some LEDs light up on the panel. Thanks for watching! Be sure to like and subscribe for more Eurorack tutorials, as well as product demos and performances from WMD.